All right, guys. I think TC, the Chosen, the team out of China, this super team, the new super team that just got made this season in the PEL, I think they are the new 4AM. Now, if you guys haven't been keeping up to speed with the Chinese scene in regards to PUBG Mobile, well, we all know that 4AM, right, was one of the most dominant teams last year in the PMGC. You see here, this is their overall rankings in the league stage. 631 points, way ahead of second place. That was BTR. And then in the grand finals of PMGC last year, 4AM managed to get second place, barely overtaking Nova for that first place spot. And yeah, so for people that don't follow the scene, we all think that you guys might think 4AM is still one of the strongest teams in the world, but that is just not the case anymore. Like right now, 4AM is one of the weaker teams in the Chinese scene. And it's not because 4AM necessarily got worse, but that's just, it's more because of how dominant and how competitive the Chinese scene is. It's just so many other teams got better than 4AM. And for the first six months of this year, China has been playing a league called PEL. It is like their own PMCO, their own PMPL that happens all year round. And for the first 6 months, 4AM was struggling really bad. They were always near the bottom. They were like a bottom 20 team. In PEL, there's a total of 20 teams, and they were always near the bottom 10, right? So after 6 months, they couldn't get it working. They decided to sell off Sook. Sook is 4AM's in-game leader. He's the guy that strategizes everything pretty much for 4AM. And they sold off Sook to TC. Now, I mentioned in the very beginning, TC is a new 4AM. Well, TC, if you guys didn't know, TC spent millions of dollars, okay? Millions of dollars this season. This season started about maybe like a month or 2 months ago. TC spent millions of dollars to put together this super team. And they bought Sook for $820,000. Okay, they bought Sook, they bought Y, they bought a few other like all-star players, and they put together this super team. And I didn't think the super team would work so quickly. It usually takes time for a super team to like establish synergy and start working well together. But they managed to do it in this season alone, and the results are there. So PEL, this is the grand finals, right? TC finally started popping off in the grand finals. So the grand finals, by the way, is still underway. We only finished day number one. If you want to watch day number 2, 3, and 4, make sure you subscribe to my YouTube. I already have the viewer parties set up. It's going to be at 5 a.m. Central Standard Time, U.S. time, 5 a.m. Central Standard Time for the next 3 days. So day number one, They already popped off. Game number 3, game number 4, they got chicken dinners. And game number 5, they didn't get the chicken dinner, but they did something that is super crazy, okay? They did the traditional 4AM strategy and got the wins on these games. But in game number 5, the very last game of the day, they did something really crazy. They did a Nova level strategy. Now, the difference, right, between Nova and 4AM was that Nova is more rotation based. They always know how to rotate more center. They know how to set up their defense in the center. 4AM last year, we saw they were a team that just absolutely killed everybody in their way. 4AM edged around the circle. They cleaned out the sides of the circle. They were just a better team in terms of aggression, and that's how they played their pace play style, right? Now, TC, I'm saying it's the new 4AM because TC bought Sook for $820,000, okay? So the way that TC plays is basically how 4AM played, but even better. It's like a super form of 4AM. It's a better version of 4AM than I've ever seen. And so their play style is very similar to 4AM, but what really amazed me was this very last game. They did a Nova level rotation. They're taking the best of what 4AM had last year, and they're also using what Nova was best at last year, doing those crazy smart 200 IQ like super rotations that we rarely get to see. And I'm going to call these rotations pocket rotations, okay? So let's take a look right here. So right here, you see TC, they're on the edge. You know, they're nowhere near the center. Nova's once again near the center, playing a traditional Nova style. TC is usually coming in off on the edge, and they're going to clear out teams. But you're going to see in this game, TC does a crazy rotation, all right? So this is a circle number two. And this is circle number two going to three, about to go into circle number four. And you're going to see 4AM. They're going to come in from all the way down here. They're going to rotate out of the zone, and they're going to come in this way. All right, now check this out. So here, you see TC coming in. They rotated all the way from into the blue out from military base, and this is a crazy rotation. Watch this. They don't clear out the edge. They don't stop to clear out the edge. Usually TC always does this, but they realize they're really late on this rotation. And they know that clearing out the edge from this spot is really difficult given the open area and the open terrain. And there's going to be multiple teams in front of them and multiple teams around them that they're going to get third party by. So Sook, the IGL, right? That was a crazy rotation right here. Check this out. He just keeps going. It's a little bit risky, don't get me wrong, but he keeps going. The rest of the team following close behind, and they just keep going. And they stop. They stop right here. Now, this is what I call a pocket rotation. There are certain zones and certain areas of the map in different maps like Erangel, Miramar, mainly those two. There's these little pockets that is safe to rotate to. Not all the time, but another example, right, that you guys are maybe more familiar with in terms of pocket rotations is a rotation like this. Let's say the end of the game, right, circle goes around this area. Let's say the circle is something like this, right? And then the circle closes, and it closes something like this. Okay, so and during the green phase of the circle, right, when the circle's this big, you're not gonna get a team playing in this area, right? It's the low ground, and if you get a team trying to play in this area, the team that is chilling up here, and there's going to be a team over here, they're going to like try and, you know, get some knocks, get some picks, and you're just going to like take a lot of shots and a lot of pressure the whole entire time you're trying to survive here, right? And then you're going to die or you're going to lose players. So this area is not usable during the green circle phase, right? But as soon as the circle shifts, and let's say you're a team that's on the edge over here, kind of like TC was, right? Kind of like TC was how on the edge way down here. Let's say you're a team on the way edge over here or over here or over here even, right? And the circle shifts to red. When this circle pops up, this is a pocket rotation. You go into this little pocket area where nobody's going to be at because like I explained earlier, if a team is there, they're probably very weak, because they've been taking shots at by teams up here and teams over here. So when this red circle pops up, what happens is all of these other teams, right, around here, they're going to look to pressure in, right? Teams around this area, they're going to look to pressure in. And then the teams up here, they're going to be busy trying to focus out and keep away other teams that are rotating in, right? They're going to be worried about that. And so because these teams are all of a sudden in this new red circle, worried about, you know, pushing teams away, that's when a pocket rotation comes into play. That's when a team can just rotate in down here, and then they just chill down here, right? Because the teams up here can no longer focus them because they have so many other teams coming in on this red circle. So you got to be like the first team in here to use the pocket rotation. The pocket rotation is one of the rarest rotations. It is one of the least like understood and utilized rotations just because it is very difficult to pull off. One, it only really works at the high level games, and you only really learn about these rotations at the high levels when you play in these games. In scrims and everything, it's hard to be sure if you could use these rotations or not, but TC, the new 4AM, the new super team, they use this rotation. They manage to get themselves into that pocket right there, right? And that new circle comes up, works out perfectly for them, right? They do get a little bit circle luck here, but I mean, like, they rotated in pretty center of the previous circle. So even if this circle didn't favor them, oh, that's the wrong one. Right? The circle's somewhat like this. The next circle, if it pops up, and so it's like this, right? It pops up like this. Let's say it goes the other side. Let's say it goes over here. Right? It goes something like that. From this position, TC, they could press away other teams, and they could still manage to press in. So they did get a little bit lucky, but it's still a really great pocket rotation strategy. And, well, I mean, you're going to want to see the rest of this game. I'm just going to play the VOD from my stream when I was watching this yesterday. And, oh, dude, TC from this position, they don't get the chicken dinner, but it is still a crazy, insane game. So you guys got to check it out. You guys got to watch the rest of it. And I'm going to just... the pocket to play in. Oh my god.
TC, 这一个炸点非常的关键.
What the f-
而刚才已经是布下阵线的 4AM 此时此刻 两眼一抹黑.
What?
难受呀, 这个全行, 你看东部首先有 TMG, 把它往东绕的这个路线隔绝了。
哎呀, 今天TC啊, 从雨林到海岛, 几波提速,
还真是恰到好处。
这个时候哪怕我跟AG打起来,
God rotations, and the circle gods, the circle gods are just blessing them.
没有问题,拿下了天宇,这个位置无不了。
That helps out TC a lot too right there.
有点夸张。其实我觉得这一波圈形的话, RNCG可以先收回东边的这个防区。
因为这个圈形是确定肯定会刷到RC，可以是要打一个收放自如，进行一个收缩。导师这边是来到了硕的旁边，路过，核心龙骨的北燕，帮他稍稍的挡住一下伤害。
You learn something new every day, right? So I guess I don't know how viable that spot is for TC if you were to try and do it in PMGC, because it'd be TPP, and teams might not be as, you know, positioned in that way, but that's the first time I've seen that spot used in that way, where you get a full team just sitting in that little pocket of that hill.
来到这个防区，第一时间是很难主动开团，剩下的真的是得看一个周围的局势了。对，要看等机会了。周围的防区一旦打起来，可以主动去劝一下。而对于SMG来说，
that's interesting spot
though。对于SMG来说太香了呀！这防区首先你可以把北部的人全部都卡死，然后你再一步上山。This
PMGC will be in TPP. Hardcore mode TPP.
一架三冲，冲下来的时候 ，Powerboy 在原点放倒了弟弟。
哎呦，那这一时间 ，STE 倒一个残一个，哎，山治还什么意思？想上吗？舒克堂，这一刻雷还封到了厕所内部，山治你听到了吗？没听到，山治听不见，山治没了，这证明了解说台的声音他们确实听不到，确实。P要的防护措施做的真好。I'm
surprised they didn't see the grenade.
隔音没有问题。那在两波连续的手雷轰炸之后 ，STE 是非常遗憾的，分别倒在了山上
4AM。 4AM just wrapped to the south behind a team to push in from their spot. Classic 4AM move right there.
而 4AM 呢, 哇,
Why did I leave competitive? There wasn't enough money to be made in competitive. Players in North America get a salary of like average, like around $1,000 USD a month. And unless if you get top three in the world, because I've been to PMGC multiple times, and that's getting like top three in North America, the money isn't that much getting top three in North America. Or the Americas, that is. You need to get top three in the world. And that's really hard to do. So I transitioned to casting. Because casting is a more consistent job and better consistent pay. Oh, Weibo's spot did not work out. Not enough control. Too easy to push in. TC pushes into zone to clear out that spot for them to use later on. And then they all go back to gatekeep. Because they don't want a team to take their spot and do what they just did to Weibo Gaming.
我很好奇啊，已经是在筷子待了许久的TMG，又是一个对于他们来讲比较致命的难切，那他们怎样出动呢？我觉得这个时候TMG应该是想封烟，然后开车去别的地方。他觉得打修弹姆的防区也不划算，因为修弹姆防区不在圈，打雷也没有用。
Showtime 也因为SMG的原因没法没有办法踩到房顶，然后周围的，哎，一个手雷放走了秋离，看不见，但是扔得着。 这又一次的拖延了TMG的一个脚步，来了，又是一个手雷炸残了阿杰，现在
TMG 想走也走不了了呀。这一处沟壑当中拖得越久啊
，SMG
其实越开心。主动出击了，99一马当先，先拉到了高点，
踩到下面之后呢？哦，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来，停下来
队友全部赶来进行支援，一头而下，完全淘汰掉了TMG，满编拿下，而且在低光当中 SMG也没有办法拉来劝阻。看一看刚刚那波回放，美滋滋下来再找人。在烟雾之中，凭借着对方的枪声找到了人。嗯，明明当时是止步于此，而对于收摊来讲，就贵在保留了一个满编啊，我依然能够向圈内进行探点。 君莫是发现了 RSG King 的一个方向，那 King 的倒地也是可以成为下一步 Showtime 的推进位置。是的，现在 TC 准备主动出击，先把这个分数补掉。但是 TC 现在是被夹了呀！啊 ，TC 绕行到了两队中间，再一次的要上演决赛圈双开吗？像是被放倒了，像素。Oh
no！
卡住了 TC 的咽喉，也给了 Showtime 进点过来搀扶队友集结的时间。但是 Showtime 那边也倒了一个人。这时间慢慢的推进下去，但闪电这个时候非常大胆呀，开始惨了，因为对方的烟雾实在是太多了，找不清楚对方的位置。YZZ 一颗手雷，致命的一打一补，一雷双响，这里只剩下经典的花痴，还有侧面的王源。闪电再铲，没铲到，斗牛式花痴。 竭尽全力的去操作自己的身法，王源顶住了，极限的反打，花痴再晃掉一下，王源还要铲吗？自己的队友这边的边缘啊，这个时候非常惊险啊，有着王源的极致反打和花痴的一个灵活走位，暂时
got too greedy to finish that. There's completely forgot about the team, the rest of the team in the back. TC could easily be 4 alive right now.
王源看到了吗？没看到，但是听到脚步了，对方跳了一下，收下了这一分。在天空中划过一道美丽的弧线，把握住了 RSG 最后的位置。TC
getting zoned last night. TC getting zoned last this game. Crazy first rotation by TC though. TC made a crazy rotation and then they got zoned bust.
反而还活下来两个人。They
should be 4 alive.
SMG 最终还是在北部达成了他们自己的部署。
I don't know why Sook got so greedy to get that finish.
自己也成为北部目前的唯一满编。
Sook left the pocket that was a safe position to try and get that thirst. He got the thirst, but he got knocked.
FM 这一局其实目前人数上是
And then they lost two of their players.
主要的思路还是打一个卡边了。对，这波绕的是真的好。我们可以发现。
这也是 4M 本赛季前五率非常之高的一大原因了。
嗯，现在镜头给到 NV 腾讯视频，他不在圈，但是他面临进圈的难处有两点，一个是高点的 RNG， 一个是低点的听拍。
对，圈型再一次的将他们切了出去，在这个防区是待的时间也较久了。
98K 这个时候崴了一下脚，
还好
缓解一下紧张的气氛
啊。对的，这场上 RNG 毕竟也是四难一防，不过 NV 腾讯视频现在正在接近 RNG 的位置，
要
扎
看这边吧。程 C 已经发现了 SMG 的一人，打残之后呢想往前走，但是小张埋在了一个非常致命的位置，这里只能打第二枪位。
逍遥已经非常非常接近小张了，小张甚至能通过草丛看到他的头，
看到一个头皮了，但是别开枪。
小江的 UMP 非常的稳，还在等一个机会。
哇，
因为自己如果第一时间落枪，我尽管换掉一个也会被老干爹剩余几人完全拿下。
是的，要等等对方露出马脚。
这个时候
开枪了，
趁着出人逍遥开枪、哎、自己的脚步逍遥不好听见，
队友都倒了还不起
来
吗？
站起
来
了，来这 UZI 一波扫射，切一个 SCAR， 三发子弹、啊、一发子弹、
哦、
四发子弹、哦、加在一块也不够反应啊。
小桑你在干嘛？
小张啊，
紧张了紧张了，
我以为你是大智若愚，没想到是有点弄巧成拙了、
哦、
那我们看一下老干爹最终是冲到了 SMG 的面前。
是的，猫猫先拉到了烟雾旁边，听到脚步了吗？但是对方先出枪放倒了猫猫。
哇、哦、那这个时候只剩下这个男人，看起来也是有一些难了。
高点还有 RNG 的枪线干扰，现在要封一颗烟打一个状态。
Tingsy was getting shot in the back by RNG。
Pigfeed 已经来到了 Love for You 的旁边，主人逍遥被补掉，没有办法去复习自己的队友。
是的， TC
Nice good kill steal by
TC， 就把握了一个最好的劝架时机。
真的往前走，看到了，先扫，杀一枪
，nice， 哦 ，that was a grenade by Chen Xi。
Chen Xi 依然有一个跟 Love for You 打单挑的机会。
Chen Xi got the double，
哇，五个淘汰，现在面对
Chen Xi with the 1v2。哦，
对的，双死星。
OK，stream froze for a second。
这是千万Chen Xi遇上银河战舰的一半，让我们看一下这一波 battle 是由王媛媛
拿下，
他拿下的也是淘汰王Chen Xi，足以让我们记住。
而且这一波 RNG 是因为有南部team派的压力，没有选择往北部炫。
现在 TC 我们看到他在西北侧的圈边，但是再往身后直到东南角才有 4M， 背后是非常非常的空。
对对对，他想要进圈的话，这个位置要么先把苏玉露对倒，要么就是依靠烟雾弹慢慢的。
Yeah, the casters are saying that SMG player is panicking or nervous， 紧张， he was nervous。
而且这个圈型里面的地形是往东北部一点，有一些反坡，可以给 TC 待一下。
以及榜首的 TC 看完之后，目前保留场上唯一满编。
Why did they call order Ling? That's order's Chinese name, Ling。
人数最多，积分也不少，
而且他在高点啊。
对，看一下 TC 的选择，王媛媛最终的也是反向要到东侧去收集一些信息。那在 4AM 向西 ，TC 向东 ，RNG 不动的情况下，先被夹的可能要是听派啊。
嗯。现在金派这个位置肯定是会被夹的，他在低点想要上山的
话，是 TC with another really good finish today
though。 而且远点还有 4M 的枪线，
TC could have four people alive though and win this game。 Well, I mean TC could still win with two, we'll see what happens。
现在你拿下的每一个淘汰，每一个排名的提升，都是自己向第一位置去追赶的机会。
RNG needs to get hurt here。
已经发力了，直接一个跳枪，但是
Nice, that's good。
哎呀，侧面的打残弹都是 UZI。
Nice, RNG lost the player。
第一时间没有跟上，只能等队友。
4M is going to come third party。 If 4M tries to come third party, TC could third party this third party。
侧面出枪打倒了星辰。
Oh, TC can win this game still, maybe。
又想把握到 4M 的反下方
向。 Oh, he didn't get
that no。 王媛媛看到周琪琪的位置，一颗火焰。
还在扔吗？
Oh, no, come on,
bro。 有点遗憾。
Too greedy, too greedy。
那这个时候花痴离自己的队友位置较远，而且王媛媛眼前有周琪琪，她的脸前还有小小剑呀。
是的，现在花痴也不能着急，要等。
Too greedy。
最好是等 4M 跟 RNG 打起来，自己再当第三方。
而且我们要知道，总决赛是一个四天的程，所以尽管 4M 再截至，今天四场比赛结束之日是场上的倒一，但如果最后一局能够获得最多的分数，也依然或许成为一个反弹的机会。
Why is too overconfident, man? Why?
钱慢慢蹭了啊。
Why sometimes just gets too overconfident?
4M 很有可能会先打起来。
三打三打一的一个对决，花痴道成为目前场上最弱的一边。4AM 跟 RNG 需要打一个平行的。
Why pops off though? Why is always overconfident like that? And most of the times it works for him.
打掉了 TC 一个人，而且 TC 之前是打过架的，还有可能会先去清 TC 的毒狼。
But
看一下。
But when it doesn't work, yeah, you see it and you're just like, he's too overconfident.
RNG 附近的一个方向，但是 4AM 去清毒狼的话呢，风险比较大吧？万一被 TC 的花痴先打掉一个的话，那 RNG.
But with TC's playstyle, you have to be overconfident. You have to be super confident.
一个摇摆人还真的就有可能是花痴，对的。
You have to be super confident because TC plays a very aggressive playstyle. You can't hesitate. You have to be that overconfident, get knocked, and your teammate has to follow it up with the same confidence and get your trade. Or you just have to trust your teammate to be just as confident as you, and you just both hard peek and kill the other players.
不过还是要看吧。因为 RNG 刚刚是打过一波架嘛，可能他的投掷物要多一些。
That's why he benched.
投掷物应该没有多少。
Yeah, so that's how Y played on the team before. Like in a different team, STE, right? Y played just as overconfident and aggressive with STE. And you can easily see how if you're on a team that's not as good as TC, with playing aggressive, and you play that way, you'll get benched. So yeah, that's why Y was benched before.
RNG 缩成一点，花痴单挂北边。但是梅花桩最终还是要到来。
But when Y is on a team like TC, and the team all plays aggressive with a very good structure, it works.
而小智是先投上投掷物，进行一个驱赶，这个火焰燃烧在了周琦琦的脚边。星辰一个人开车过来，这不是白给吗？
直接
从车里飞了出去，倒在了威无限的旁边。
RNG can needs to get at least one knock. 大胆往前进行试探，躲过这个枪线冲锋，威无限
再次进行补枪。RNG 只剩下小智一个人，有点无力回天啊！三打一打一了，而这个时候花痴迟迟的没有出手，他应该也知道此时人数更多的就是。
Stop peeking! Stop peeking!
这个一下。一打一打
二，好像再
次陷入危险。不过第一时间又看到了小智左右开弓啊，他那个头皮差一点点没有打到。我们看到花痴，他是一个三倍镜的 MPU 啊，子弹较高。
Oh, that grenade
也是让他原点稍微压低一
点。Oh, so close！
差一点点，哎呦
！He's got one more. He's got one more.
第二颗手雷。
Oh, that one's gonna hit.
判断的没错的。哎，不着急，有反动。
Oh, that's too far. He gets knocked out.
周琦琦，小小剑，先瞄小小剑的位置，但是侧面魏无羡来了。
Damn, that RNG player was not helping.
现在是二打一，小智的一个一打二，提前起身，如果能够先秒掉一个，但是他是短剑维克多呀，这一句让我们恭喜 4AM。这其实也真的是一个。
All right, so TC is a new 4AM, but 4AM do end up winning that match.All right, so this was just all the action from that very last game. If you want to watch the rest, go to my YouTube channel. Well, you're already on my YouTube channel, but you just go through my past streams and you can watch this whole entire day in its entirety. And also, we still got day 2, day 3, and day 4 left to go. So those links to those viewer parties will be like down below. I'll put them in the YouTube description. And hopefully I'll see you guys tomorrow. Can't wait to see who ends up being the champions of the Season 3 Grand Finals. And also, these points that these teams are getting will determine who will play at the PMGC at the very end of the year. So these games are super important. And I'm super pumped to see how the next 3 days goes. All right, see you guys tomorrow, hopefully. Be there or be square, I guess. I don't know. Okay, Zoo Nation out.